Hello everyone, this is Engineer Lab, and today we are going to talk about this powerful edge bridge motor driver called BTS7960, and we are also going to show you how to access that and work with Arduino and BTS7960 to do a lot of more stuffs. So let's get started. Our BTS7960 actually looks like this. So there are two microchips. You can see there is written BTS7960, BTS7960. So these microchips work as a edge bridge motor driver and drive motors like big and small ones also. So we will talk about that. And there are 8 pins that are used to control the motor driver, and behind that we have a battery in, battery positive negative, motor out, motor positive negative. So with these pins we control and connect to Arduino or any other microcontroller. So in this video we will work with this Arduino board. So these 8 pins here, VCC, ground are these 8 pins, VCC and ground. So accordingly the other pins are mentioned in the list. So RIS, LIS, REN, LEN, RPWM, LPWM are mentioned here. So the other pins RIS, REN, RPWM, LPWM, in these pins we will connect RIS to ground and LIS to ground and REN and LEN to 5 volt pin so that we can get a nice controlling. And RPWM and LPWM, these two pins are PWM pins, so we should be careful about connecting these two pins to PWM pins of Arduino. And other thing, this motor driver can hold up to 43 ampere of current, so that's a huge current. We will easily drive this motor to that bigger size motors or other than bigger. So this will easily control and drive these motors. So let's connect it to the Arduino. We will need a motor. I have took the 400 RPM DC geared motor with this T plug connected, so that will make it easy. And there is a BTS Arduino Uno and some jumpers, so let's connect it to the Arduino. I have connected all the jumpers to the 8 pins of BTS. So now this 2 pins of first 2 corner, that's called VCC and ground, this will go to the Arduino 5 volt and ground pin, and the other pins accordingly, like the upper section, will take that pins and straightly connect it to Arduino's 1, 2 and 3. Okay, and the lower section, 3 pins will go to the pins from 4 to 6. Okay, so what we have connected here is digital pin 1 and 2 to RIS and REN, and digital pin 3 to RPWM. This should be PWM pin. digital 4 and digital 5 to LIS and LEN, and the digital 6 that should be PWM, because that is LEN, and the other two, that's our VCC and ground. So I have connected it successfully. I have connected the battery connection to the BTS using this point, and also connected a motor of 400 rpm. So let's upload the code. But here is a thing I should mention: the battery ground connection should be connected to Arduino ground pin also, otherwise it cannot work or operate perfectly. So our wiring is done. Let's upload the code and see how the motor works. Here is our code that we are going to upload on the Arduino. So we have got 6 variables: RIS, REN, RPWM, R and LIS, LEN, LPWM. So we have set that all to the output, and here is a thing we should see: RIS, LIS, REN and LEN. These pins should be accordingly low, low and high, high. So only the RPWM and LPWM pins will operate according to the PWM signal. So first, in the loop section, we will declare two loops, and first our RPWM will rise from 0 to 255, and then another loop LPWM will rise from 0 to 255. Here RPWM rises where the LPWM is 0, and when the LPWM rises, the RPWM is 0. So that's so important, because if we rise the signal PWM for both of RPWM and LPWM, the chip will burn. So first of all, we will get a clockwise rotation and then a counterclockwise rotation. So in this process, we will be able to see they are speeding up, speeding down, and also we are going to see the direction change of motor. After uploading the sketch, you can see the motor is running clockwise, then counterclockwise, and to show the speeding up and rotation changing, we will insert a tire. Now you can see, okay, that's a lot of speed. Now that's counterclockwise, that's speeding up time to time and changing its rotation. So with the BTS 7960, we can do a lot of things like this and control various kind of motors. So that's it for today. Please subscribe our YouTube channel and turn on the bell icon for more of these exciting videos. Every week we will come to you with new and exciting projects. Be a part of that. Be safe, be happy, and we will see you next time.